Hello, this is Artem Barsky, co-founder of Ethereum. In our previous video, we looked how to start the analysis of ChIP-Seq data. Let's see how to look at the results and what's important there. So we're going into our project. This is our ChIP-Seq sample. This is JuneB ChIP-Seq in activated T cells. So you can see here is the pie chart that shows percentage of the reads that got aligned. Here you can see the statistics more detailed. You can see 82% of the reads got aligned. This is good. This is first the trimming statistics by trim galore. You can see the trim galore detected Nextera transposase adapter sequence. This is good because we use chip mutation. Here is alignment statistics, bump statistics, and peak calling statistics. You can see we got a lot of peaks called. Let's look at our peaks on the genome browser. So here we click at IGV genome browser tab and wait for the data to load. Since this is JuneB in T cells, let's look at the IL-2 gene. Here you can see the peak coverage, the coverage by reads around the IL-2 gene. Let's zoom out to see the peaks better. So these are the big peaks. You can see that these are the peaks that Max2 found to be significant here. And you can see also the list of peaks in the peak calling tab, which shows the table with all the peaks. Here in this table, you can see the peak coordinates. They are actually in the middle. So this is chromosome start and end of the peak. On the left, you can see what are the nearest genes to the peak. And you get both ReFSEQ ID, gene name, and gene start and its strand. You can also see peak characteristics such as the length, summit, p-value, pileup, q-value, and also where it is located relative to the gene. It can be promoter, intergenic, upstream, and so on. Before going to the analysis, let's look at some of the other QC plots. So the one in the top left is the base frequency plot. It shows the frequency of each base at each coordinate. And you can see that our sequence is 80 rich, as is human genome. Sometimes, for example, when analyzing RNA-seq data, you will see that all bases are equally represented, and this is because the genes are not 80 rich compared to the whole genome. But for ChIP-Seq, where you expect the peaks to be outside the genes, you can expect the reads to be 80 rich, as we see here. Another control is straight out quality scores for each base in the read, and in this case, quality is pretty good from 35 to 40. Average tag density around the transcription start site of the genes is usually not very useful for transcription factor ChIP-Seq, but it is very useful for histone modification ChIP-Seq, such as H3K43 methylation or H3K27 acetylation or ataxic. But here, nonetheless, we see an enrichment of reads around transcription start site, suggesting that JuneB often binds to the promoter of the genes. Finally, we have a very cool graph, which is called ChIP-Seq estimates. And this actually estimates whether you would improve your sequencing result if you get more reads. So right now we have about 50 million reads. And this means we have about 5 million of 6 million of about 5 million of unique reads. If we sequence more reads, so for example, if we go to 200 million reads, we will get about 34 million reads. So this shows the diversity of our library and can inform you whether you want to sequence more of this library. Finally, let's look at the file tab. And this is where you can download all the data files. So this includes, for example, the FASTQ files, the BAM files, statistics files, list of the peaks, and so on. And on the last tab, workflow, you can look at the description of workflow and can also look at the steps that we have here. Thank you. And in the next video, we will look at how to compare ChIP-Seq data between two different conditions and also how to test what are the motifs that are enriched in the ChIP-Seq peaks using Homer. Thank you, and I'll see you in the next video.